Hi, my name is Matthias. I'm in Zimbabwe, and this is a flat rock scorpion, a species of scorpion that can be found throughout southern Africa. They can grow up to 20 centimeters, which makes them one of the heaviest and largest scorpion species in the world. But the size of the scorpion makes little difference to how dangerous they are. A small baby thick-tailed scorpion can deliver a very painful and potentially even dangerous sting compared to the mild prick of a rock scorpion. So how can you tell if a scorpion is dangerous or not? Well, when it comes to scorpions, there is a great rule of thumb. The larger the stinger and smaller the pincers, the more venomous and thus dangerous the scorpion species is. Evolution has given scorpions with smaller pincers a more potent and effective venom, sort of as a compensation. Compare this, for example, with the enormous pincers of this Asian forest scorpion. It can grab onto its prey, squeeze and crush it, so it doesn't need a very potent venom to be able to control its victim. And as a side note, the word venomous is used when a dangerous or toxic liquid is injected into the body, and the word poisonous is used when the dangerous or toxic liquid is ingested into the body. So, in this case, judging by its large pincers relative to its slender stinger, we can presume that this flat rock scorpion is harmless. A gentle giant, as you will. Well, sort of. Indeed, its sting is barely noticeable compared to a bee sting or the thorn of an acacia tree. But the flat rock scorpion is an ambush predator, and it makes very good use of its large pincers. You see, doing its name justice, it loves squeezing its flat body between the cracks of the rocks and grab any unlucky critter that passes by. And another very cool thing about this scorpion is that scorpions have cuticular fluorescence. They absorb ultraviolet lighting and re-emit it as visible light, thus visible to the human eye. Let me demonstrate. But the evolutionary purpose of scorpions' bioluminescent abilities is a biological mystery. Scorpions are actually always glowing under normal light, just too faintly for us to observe. Around 6 hypotheses exist about the usefulness of this fluorescence, from attracting prey, communication and/or signaling for mating purposes, to even a remaining relic trait that acted as a sun protection hundreds of millions of years ago, from the times they were exposed to a more intense ultraviolet radiation. It might even be an evolutionary accident that scorpions fluoresce. Some minerals fluoresce, and clearly they don't have a purpose for this. They are rocks. However, the theory that is most agreed upon by scientists is that fluorescing helps scorpions detect and, more importantly, avoid ultraviolet light. Allow me to explain. Scorpions are nocturnal animals, and they only like to go out on the darkest nights, because sunlight will take moisture out of their bodies, and foraging makes them vulnerable to predators. But how do they figure out whether or not there is sunlight or even moonlight outside? Well, with their eyes, of course, but it has been shown that scorpions can actually detect light even when they are blinded, thanks to special light receptors on their body. As such, it is believed that scorpions use their whole body as some kind of light detection device. They convert ultraviolet light to a blue-green glow and then transmit this signal to their nervous system,
making their whole body act as a third eyeball that is way more sensitive to even the slightest differences in brightness outside. In theory, this would help a scorpion hide better at night. It could tell which part of its body is in the shade and move its body towards that shade to find shelter without having to use its eyes. But we have to keep in mind that these are just theories and that we might never unravel the true purpose of scorpions' bioluminescence.